appreciate you guys all staying on through that technical difficulty. So basically the video is very inspirational. How about how about this? I will post it in the Team B page so you can see what the intention was behind it. But basically it's the idea of that there's never a perfect opportunity. There's never the right time. There's never going to be, the stars are never going to align for you in anything. It was a video of showing like pro athletes who when they realized that there was a goal that they wanted to achieve, how much they had to fight for it, how much they had to fight to make it happen. And it was talking about how the perfect opportunity and the perfect experience is never going to fall into your lap. But you know what? You are the thing that can make it more, you can create that perfect opportunity. So how do you create that perfect opportunity? How do you create the perfect storm? It's called discipline. It's called discipline. I'm going to say that word again, discipline. So do you think those the top athletes out there, do you really think that their bodies always feel like working out? That their bodies always feel like going to practice? That their mind always feels like going and getting yelled at today by my coach? Do you think that there are days when they just want to take a day off and rest? Absolutely. Absolutely there are. And so in life and just like our coaching businesses, there's never going to be this perfect time where all of it's just so easy and it all just falls into place. It takes discipline. And at the beginning of my coaching journey, I read a book. It's called The Slight Edge. And I believe it's called by Jeff Olson. And many of you guys have read The Compound Effect, and quite frankly, The Compound Effect, I think, is the newer version of The Slight Edge, okay? But one of the things that literally Jeff Olson says in The Slight Edge that I love so much is those little daily disciplines that we do every day that help us hit our goal are so easy to do, but guess what? They're even easier not to do. I'm going to say that again. They're really easy to do, and they're really easy not to do. So for example, like I bet you there's probably at least five coaches right now on our team that are currently not doing anything pressing right now. They just chose, I'm going to call in, or I'm going to listen to the recording on Monday. I'll listen to the recording sometime later this week. So was it easy for you to call in here? Maybe it was, maybe it wasn't. But would it have been really easy for you not to log in? Absolutely, it would be. And the thing that's interesting about discipline, and he talks about in The Slight Edge, is, okay, I can't remember if it was The Slight Edge or The Compound Effect. I always get them confused. Talk about, for example, we've all heard an apple a day. You can all finish the phrase, right? An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Like, I didn't even have to say it, right? You all know what it is, right? An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Have you ever considered what the saying would be? A Hershey bar a day. What would that do? So if I ate a Hershey bar tomorrow, would it give me diabetes? No, it wouldn't give me diabetes. And if I ate a Hershey bar 2 or 3 days in a row, would it give me diabetes? No, probably not. But if I ate a Hershey bar every day, for the next 365 days, do you think it would have the possibility of giving me diabetes? Yes. Yes. Absolutely. So anything that's easy to do is also easy not to do, right? but it just takes discipline. Also the same with our workouts, right? If we don't do it today, are we going to like put on 5 pounds? Probably not. But if we skip our workout for 6 months, you know, could we possibly put on 5 pounds? Heck yes, we could, right? So again, easy to do, easy not to do. So the thoughts are, guys, is every single little discipline that we have, no matter big or how small, either gets you closer to or moves you further away from your goal, whatever that is. And the part that's interesting, have you ever noticed this? Discipline begets discipline, begets discipline, begets discipline. So meaning, if you have multiple disciplines, so let's say, for example, I'm going to share with you my disciplines, okay? My daily disciplines that I do, gosh, kind of crazy how long of a list it is, okay? My daily disciplines, I meditate for at least 5 minutes. I drink my Shakeology. I do my workout. What do I do every day? I post on Facebook at least on the weekdays, right? Generally speaking. And I don't know, I'll come up with more. Anyway, so those are my disciplines, right? So what, and clean eating, okay? What happens is one builds upon the other. Oh gosh, we even have more disciplines than that. We just don't think of them. Like I brush my teeth every day. I make my bed every day. I get dressed every day, right? I mean, little things that build upon each other. I shave one leg. Yeah, that's right. One. I shave one leg a day to shave time. I go back and forth, okay, right? So if there was, when I leave out one discipline, it's so easier to not do the rest. Have you ever noticed when you miss that first thing that's your discipline list for the day, when you miss that first one, it's so much easier not to do the rest. It's like, I didn't meditate this morning, or I didn't do my workout this morning. When it comes to clean eating, am I going to be as disciplined today? Maybe not. Okay. So all of these disciplines are easy to do. They're easy not to do. But the part that's interesting is, like I said, when you give up one, they all start to go away. So what I'm asking you to really sit and contemplate, what are your own daily disciplines? And do you have any that are the catalyst for your day? That's generally your one you do first in the day, that you know that if you miss that one discipline, that's going to throw everything off, else off. Mine is meditation. If I don't meditate first thing in the morning, it's probably not going to happen. And I'm not as calm. I'm not as patient. I'm not as productive. I don't eat as clean. Like that discipline makes everything make or break for me. Do you have any of those? And if you do, what are they? What are they? And then the next thing I want you to think about truly is as far as there not being any perfect storm. They're not being a perfect storm for success, that we have to create it. I think the hard part is right now for so many people is the plate's too full, right? The plate is so full. The plate is so full. And we want to do it all so desperately. And we want to do it all well so desperately. But the hard part is there's only 24 hours in a day, and there's only so much time to allocate where. So it's up to you to prioritize what disciplines are the most important to you. What disciplines that you put in place are going to get you closer to your goal? And have you noticed what are the small, like, anti-disciplines that sometimes you can be tempted to do that move you further away from your goal? Are there any of those things that move you further away from your goal, like a candy bar or a nightly alcoholic beverage get you further away than just saving it for other times. But as far as the daily disciplines are concerned in time management, this is just, I know we're about at time. This is just one more thing I want to touch on. Okay. As far as the perfect storm, as in talking to several of my personally sponsored coaches lately and just hearing about how full people's plates are and going from one thing to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next. I would love us all to take a deep breath. And if you haven't really truly contemplated what your priorities are, and are the things that you're doing on a daily basis adding to and supporting that, or are they just making you more busy and more tired and more stressed and so on? Like, say for example, you know, I know a lot of parents want to be involved in everything at their kids' schools. Like, we want to, right? We want to be a part of the PTA, and we want to help with this, and we want to help with that. We want to go into the kids' classes and do all of that stuff, which is awesome and honorable. But if you're struggling to pay your bills right now, what do you think would honor your family more? Spreading yourself a little bit more thin to be involved and be present in more things? Or do you think it would be maybe taking a couple things off your plate so you could be disciplined with your power hour? So you could fit that in every day? Because I know so many of you want to work this business and you want to help people and you want so desperately in your heart to be that coach that's going to change lives for people. I know so many of you want that. And if you really want it, then that means taking things off the plate that aren't getting you closer to the goal, that might just be things that you feel like you're supposed to do. So I'm asking you to really contemplate how you spend your time and how you do those daily disciplines. So ask yourself, or how I'm spending my time getting me closer to my goal. And if your goal is you want to spend all your time with your family, that's awesome and be really present. I love that and I honor that. But again, if you're struggling to pay your bills, maybe talking to your partner about reallocating, maybe just a little bit more adjustment here or a tweak there to your schedule to help and allow. Imagine how much stress it will take off your plate. Yeah, you might have a little bit of guilt that you're not doing it all, but isn't just a little bit of guilt better than feel like you're pulling your hair out because you're trying to do too much, because you're not doing anything well? And I know all of us wouldn't be here right now if we weren't striving or looking for a way to be that amazing coach. So I'm asking you to really sit and contemplate two things this week. Your daily disciplines, are you doing them? Is there that one discipline that you do that if you miss it, maybe it's your workout. Maybe it's your workout first thing in the morning. If you miss your workout, your diet goes to hell. If you miss your workout, nothing else happens. Maybe you miss your time blocks for the day and all of that. So identify your disciplines, your one major discipline that sets them all. And then three, are there any activities that you have on your plate that is just filler? That's just white carbs. In essence, right? It's just white carbs in your life. It's just filler that you're doing it more out of ego, feeling that it's something you're supposed to do. If I'm a good mom, I'd do this. If I were a good husband, I'd do this. If I were a good wife, I'd do this. If I were a good employee, I should do this. If I were a good Christian, I should do this. If I'm a good, whatever labels that you put on that you think you're supposed to be doing. Are any of those things not getting you closer to where you want to be? Because if they're not getting you closer to where you want to be, they're moving you far. They're moving you further away. It's one or the other. And guess what? We all want to be the change we want to see in the world, or we wouldn't be here right now. So I love you all so much. I know you're all doing your best. I know we all are doing our best, but guess what? We're all a work in progress. So we all can do a little bit better every day. And I honor each and every one of you for being present right here, right now, because I know it would have been easy to skip this call. And I honor each and every one of you who are watching recorded, to this, because again, that's another discipline of just plugging into that personal development on a on a weekly basis. So thank you so much for being present. And we will talk to you next week. Have a great one. You guys, it's Halloween season. Take advantage. Reach out, help people, because you know what? This is the time when they want your help. It's coming. Okay? Have a great time. Great weekend. Bye, guys.